David. Tom Brady.
Domestic spying. President Bush strongly defends his intelligence program again after a new report that some of his most trusted advisors were not so sure it was legal. Second wave. More rain and flooding batter the West Coast. California's wine country braces for the worst. After the storm, the long road back. A new year in the hurricane zone. How one Mississippi family is showing faith in the future. And the bear facts. Grizzlies, their numbers are on the rise, renewing a big debate that could lead to a showdown between bureaucrat and beast.
From NBC News World Headquarters in New York, this is NBC Nightly News with John Seigenthaler.
Good evening, everyone. President Bush began the new year the same way he ended 2005, defending his domestic spying program. The president said again today that it was vital to the nation and that the leak revealing the program had damaged the United States. His defense followed published reports today that even some of his closest advisors weren't sure the spying was legal. NBC's Tom Costello joins us tonight from the White House with the story. Good evening, Tom.
John, good evening to you. The president today saying yet again in a very strongly worded defense that if Al-Qaeda is trying to call someone, the government should know who and why.
The president's first visit of the year was to San Antonio today, where he met with some of the wounded and staff at Brooke Army Medical Center, and where Mr. Bush felt compelled to again defend the secret White House program to monitor email traffic and listen into the phone calls of as many as 500 Americans each day without court approval. Mr. Bush said only international calls to and from the U.S. and involving known Al-Qaeda sympathizers were tapped.
It seems logical to me that if we know there's a phone number associated with Al-Qaeda and or an Al-Qaeda affiliate, and they're making phone calls, it makes sense to find out why.
The president again emphasized Congress was kept informed of the program that was regularly reviewed by the Justice Department and found to be legal. But the New York Times today reported that then-Deputy Attorney General James Comey resisted approving parts of the spying program out of concern that it wasn't legal. And Newsweek reports in a cover story that then Attorney General John Ashcroft refused to overrule Comey. While Time magazine says the president even bypassed top Justice Department attorneys who normally review top secret intelligence programs. The president returned to Washington this afternoon with senators from both parties calling for hearings into whether the administration violated a 30-year-old law that prohibits spying on Americans without a court order.
Unilaterally changing the law because the vice president or president thinks it's wrong without discussion or change, that's not the American way.
The facts are that the president believes very, very strongly that he has the constitutional authority and that the resolution we passed in 2001 in the war on terror gives him the authority to do what he did.
Republican Arlen Specter, the chairman of the Judiciary Committee, says he's not so sure he wants hearings by the end of the month. Today, also Senator Richard Lugar of Indiana says he too supports hearings. Meanwhile, the FBI continues to look into who leaked the existence of the program in the first place. John?
NBC's Tom Costello. Tom, thanks. Now to the severe weather pounding the West Coast this weekend. A new rainstorm hit California today, bringing more rain and more flooding. NBC's Jennifer Lunda joins us again tonight from Guerneville, California. Good evening, Jennifer.
John, good evening. The powerful winter storms hitting the West are to blame for at least one death. And in Guerneville early this morning, the Russian River crested at 10 feet above flood stage. It's the last thing people living along the Russian River wanted to see today, more rain. By mid-morning, the nasty weather had returned and Guerneville received another soaking. All the rain is not just drenching homes and businesses, it's now starting to drain the local economy. Take a drive downtown and you'll see shops and restaurants with sandbags stacked outside instead of welcome signs. For motel owner Michael Kennett, New Year's is usually one of the busiest times of the year. Instead, most of his 20 rooms are empty. Kennett says he's now worried about the storm's long-term impact.
The resorts here are totally dependent upon visitors coming up, and if they haven't got the confidence to come up or think we're devastated too.
And today, the Coast Guard released this video of yesterday's dramatic rescue of a woman from her flooded car in Marin County. While in Napa, the heart of California's wine country, winemakers say they're grateful for a drainage system they recently installed.
Vines are dormant, right now, they're sleeping. They can take up to about 2 weeks of rain and flooding before there's any problems.
And in hard-hit Reno, Nevada, where floodwaters continue to rise, work crews struggle to keep major roads open. In Pasadena, volunteers have been putting the finishing touches on the floats for the Rose Parade, despite the gloomy forecast for Southern California.
The next storms are going to be pounding Southern California, and as we know, there are a lot of burn areas down there that have less of an ability to manage high rates of rainfall as they have in the past.
And back in Guerneville, some longtime residents were determined to carry on, even if that meant paddling just to get around town. The main roads in and out of town are still proving to be a challenge for drivers, and it may be days before the Russian River recedes below flood stage. John, and today's heavy rain isn't helping.
Jennifer London in Northern California. Jennifer, thank you. In Texas and Oklahoma, more wildfires have broken out, fanned by high winds and high temperatures. In Mineral Wells, Texas, buildings have been completely consumed by flames as firefighters try to prevent the blaze from spreading. Record highs in the 80s are adding to concerns about preventing new fires. It's one of the oldest holidays in the world, and this weekend, millions of Americans stayed up late to ring in 2006. NBC's Pat Dawson tonight with a look at the celebrations.
New Year's in America began with the traditional. A huge crowd gathered in Times Square for the ball drop. A huge party on the streets of Las Vegas. A television tradition returned as well. Dick Clark, whose stroke a year ago kept the 76-year-old performer out of the public eye almost entirely, returned to host his New Year's broadcast.
Back where he belongs, the one and only Mr. Dick Clark.
Though with a hoarse voice and speech sometimes hard to understand, suggesting that after a half century, the American TV icon whose career began with American Bandstand might be passing from the scene.
That I wouldn't have missed this for the world.
After midnight, all was not peaceful in New York City, where four murders were reported. A jarring surprise for city officials who just announced that the city's murder rate had fallen to levels not seen in 40 years. On New Year's Day, Philadelphia trotted out its own tradition. The Mummers Parade, a strutting dress-up ball with a Mardi Gras feel that dates back to colonial times. And in the home of the Mardi Gras this morning, what was billed as an interfaith celebration. After the ravages of Hurricane Katrina, a chance for the city of good times to reflect on what's been lost and how much has been regained.
This is a very special day, and I'm so happy to see 2005 get behind us and to have 2006 right in front of us.
A New Year's spirit of revival in a city learning to live again. Pat Dawson, NBC News, New York.
Along the Gulf Coast and neighboring Mississippi, also hard hit by Katrina, the survivors are struggling also to put 2005 behind them and make a fresh start with a new year. NBC's Ron Mott has that story.
In Bay St. Louis, Mississippi, this New Year's Sunday, there's virtually nothing left to celebrate, but there's everything that keeps a community together.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Shared sorrow and a common commitment to overcome.
I want them to realize that they have learned a lot about themselves, about their faith, about their community, about their inner resources.
For Jay and Colleen Trapani and their twin boys, Taylor and Tyler, Katrina taught them a life's worth of lessons.
Y'all glad to be home?
Mm-hmm.
A day before the storm hit, the family scrambled to get out of their beachfront house in the neighboring town of Waveland. 3 days after Katrina, all that remained were these front steps and a slew of strewn memories, an emptiness the Trapanis can see and feel every day now from their new home away from home.
I told my seven-year-olds that their life began at seven, and every picture that we lost prior to that, you know, they were born at seven, and we're moving forward from here.
And so is everyone else. Nearly 75,000 Mississippians are living in trailers or mobile homes like the Trapanis. That's why, despite today's holiday and the weather, there's no downtime, too much work to be done.
The new year starts shrouded in fog here, but families like the Trapani say it's clear that while they may have lost many treasures from the past, the real riches lie in the present and the future.
Yesterday we found CDs and mama's dress.
The Trapanis are thrilled to salvage anything from their former lives, but it's the deeper connections with one another and friends like Jimmy Pace they value most.
Every material thing can be replaced, but the friendships.
You can't replace them and you can't destroy it. It's something that's going to be there.
An optimistic outlook from those who could have easily given up.
Keep moving forward. There's no alternative.
But have chosen to persevere in 2006 and beyond. Ron Mott, NBC News, Bay St. Louis, Mississippi.
After deadly storms, rising fuel prices, and a fairly flat stock market, what might we see for 2006? When we asked CNBC's Michelle Caruso Cabrera to wrap up the year just passed and give us an economic look ahead in her own words.
Well, I think one of the high points is that we saw an improvement in the economy compared to last year. And certainly a low point was Katrina and how much the nation suffered and the economy suffered and the high gas prices that came about as a result. Most of the economists are telling us that next year we're probably going to see a slight slowdown in the U.S. economy. Energy has so many unknown variables that really worry the economists. What if there's some kind of terrorist attack in the Middle East that disrupts oil production? What if we get another hurricane season like last year that disrupts refinery production even more? Last year, it was the consumer who drove the economy. But right now, consumer debt is very high, and a lot of economists think that consumers are going to slow down their spending in 2006.
That's it, Mom?
Yeah. Consumers are looking at huge increases in their heating bills. When you get a bill that is suddenly double what it was last year, that's money that you can't spend going out to dinner, going to the movies, buying a new dress or suit. The other thing that they're worried about is housing. The real question is what happens to mortgage rates. If they start to go up dramatically, they think we could really see a decline in pricing. There will still be gains in home prices, but not the 15% that we've been getting year after year. The market was not a highlight of 2005. The Dow did nothing this year, flat. All the analysts are saying next year is going to be better and that we are going to see gains. They do argue that when you have a flat year, the likelihood of next year being better goes up quite a bit.
CNBC's Michelle Caruso Cabrera tonight in her own words. We turn to Iraq now, where there was no peace on this first day of the new year. One U.S. soldier died of wounds sustained in a mortar attack. In the northern city of Kirkuk, Iraqi forces opened fire on a crowd protesting higher oil prices, killing four people. There were a dozen bombings today, eight in Baghdad alone, killing two people and wounding 20. When NBC Nightly News continues this Sunday, in depth, new year, new laws, whether it's about driving, drugs, or your diet, how the rules might affect you in 2006, and the fate of the grizzlies, should these bears in one of America's most famous national parks stay on the endangered list?
Betsy, you've won $1 million in the Publishers Clearinghouse sweepstakes.
Fantastic thing.
It happens all the time. Real people really win the Publishers Clearinghouse sweepstakes.
I'm telling you, it's just so amazing.
I just knew it was going to happen. Yes.
And it'll happen again. February 28th, the Prize Patrol could surprise you with $10 million live on TV. Enter by mail or go to PCH.com.
I thought she was wasting her time.
Really?
And on February 28th, our next $10 million winner could be you.
You sweep, then you mop. You sweep, then you mop. And it's still a mess, until now. Hi, Saul Judah here for the Sweep and Mop, the only mop in the world that sweeps and mops at the same time, guaranteeing professional cleaning in half the time. Look, this is the kind of stuff you normally sweep or vacuum first. Dirt, dust, dog hair, cat hair, doesn't matter. And there's soda, but wait, here's more. Watch this. With the Sweep and Mop, whether you push or pull, the dirt, the dust, the debris gets trapped along the ridges every time, leaving you clean, beautiful floors in just seconds. And unlike your old-fashioned sponge and string mops, Sweep 'Em Up acts like a water magnet, soaking up all this liquid with no drips. That's incredible. Look, would you do this with your old-fashioned mop? Not a chance. The secret is in the Sweep 'Em Up's patented ridge cleaning system that traps the dirt while millions of micropockets lock in and hold the liquid. Now remember, you can sweep and mop all at the same time, on any floor surface, on any mess. Now, cleaning and sweeping them up couldn't be easier. Just look how all that dirt, hair, and grime just glides right off. The best part of fall is the price. The incredible sweep them up can be yours for only $10. But wait, if you call now, we'll double the offer and give you a second sweep them up free. That's a $40 value, still only $10. Just pay shipping and handling. And as a special bonus, you'll get free sweep them up replacement heads for life. Call now and get it all. Not one, but two sweep them ups and free replacement heads for life. All for only $10. Sweep 'em Up is the last mop you'll ever buy, the only mop you'll ever need. Here's how to order.
To order your Sweep 'em Up for only $10 plus $7.95 shipping and handling, call 1-800-957-0250. Call now. You must be 18 years or older to order.
Monday, your credit card minimum payments are about to skyrocket. We'll sort out the new regulations. NBC Nightly News with Brian Williams, Monday.
NBC News in depth tonight, playing by new rules. With the new year, there are now a raft of new laws on the books. From the rising price of stamps to new food label regulations, there are some changes for all of us. Here's NBC's Pete Williams.
Starting today in California, drivers under 18 must wait a year after getting their licenses before they can carry their friends as passengers, unless there's an adult in the car. It's the latest in state restrictions on young drivers, intended to cut down on potential distractions.
Studies show that when a teenager drives with one passenger, their risk of being in a fatal crash doubles compared to driving alone. When you add two or more passengers, that crash risk goes up by five times instead of driving alone.
And first-year drivers in California can no longer drive between 11 p.m. and 5 a.m. Beginning today, a bigger federal tax credit kicks in for buyers of hybrid cars that run on gas and electricity, more than $3,000 for some models. The new Medicare prescription drug benefit goes into effect today. Those eligible have until May to sign up. Recent surveys show nearly 40% still have not decided.
And anyone wanting to write a letter complaining about new laws will have to spend 2 cents more to mail it, starting a week from today.
On January 8th, the first class stamp goes up to 39 cents from 37. The Postal Service says it has plenty of 2-cent stamps available for customers with the older ones to use up. Today brings new federal laws regulating what labels on food must show about what's inside. A new line appears for foods that contain what's called trans fat, which can raise cholesterol levels and increase the risk of heart disease.
The daily values are calculated on the basis of nutrients that are required for good health. And it's important to understand that neither trans fatty acids nor saturated fat are required for good health.
And starting today, labels must clearly show whether foods contain the most common substances that cause allergies, from peanuts and milk to shellfish and eggs. Pete Williams, NBC News, Washington.
When we come back, the new year in Russia, where that country's president is under fire for eroding democratic reforms.
Brad, you still need to choose a Medicare drug plan.
Oh, the big fight's about to start.
Well, you don't want a big fight to start in here, do you? Besides, you could be saving money.
Wait just a minute. How much?
Says here Pacific Air could save you hundreds, even thousands of dollars.
Thousands?
One thing the good old days didn't have is Medicare drug coverage. Now, if you're Medicare eligible, Prescription Solutions from PacificCare makes the new drug coverage even better, offering a variety of plans starting under $23 a month. Call us anytime, 24 hours a day, to get our free prescription drug plan information kit. In addition to our Medicare drug plans, PacificCare also offers dental and vision programs starting at just $5 a month. There's still time to get coverage starting January 1st. So call right now to get more out of Medicare drug coverage with PacificCare. If Fred could have done it, he would have.
We asked Lindsay Allen how new Ambien CR helped her with her sleeping trouble. Well, there you are. New Ambien CR has a controlled-release formula in a two-layer tablet. The first layer dissolves quickly to help you get to sleep fast, while the second layer dissolves slowly to help you stay asleep. So you can wake up and get ready for your day. New Ambien CR is one of many treatment options, in addition to lifestyle changes, that you and your doctor can consider. Ambien CR is non-narcotic. Until you know how Ambien CR will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Side effects may include next-day drowsiness, dizziness, and headache. You shouldn't take it with alcohol. All sleep medicines carry some risk of dependency. Do not use sleep medicines for extended periods without first talking to your doctor. Be sure you are able to devote 7 to 8 hours to sleep before you need to be active again. Ask your doctor about the new Ambien. New Ambien CR. Tomorrow will thank you.
Dateline Sunday. She hoped sending her son to boot camp would clean up his life. Instead, it ended it. An accident or discipline taken too far. Dateline tonight, NBC 7, 6 Central.
If you've seen a mattress at Hanes any time in the last year, this is your last chance ever to get it. 9 a.m. Monday, Hanes will liquidate our current inventory of brand name mattresses. The lowest price you'll ever get on a new mattress is the day we get rid of it, when a $1,000 European pillow top goes for $395. And Kingsdown's worth almost $2,000 are $733. Get your luxury mattress for less than anyone ever has and pay nothing till 2007 when we liquidate our current inventory of mattresses. 9 a.m. Monday at Hanes.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, NBC 12 Weather Plus is coming.
In his first New Year's message, Pope Benedict called for the courage to promote peace. Addressing the crowd in a rainy St. Peter's Square, the Pope urged the world to prevent terrorism and stressed that war could not be an excuse for disregarding humanitarian law. On to Moscow, where the new year has brought a new leadership role. Today, Russia took over chairmanship of the G8 group of leading industrial democracies. But the new position comes amid controversy over a Kremlin crackdown on democratic reforms. Here's NBC's Preston Mendenhall.
As the Kremlin bells struck midnight, thousands on Red Square celebrated the start of 2006. Which also marks 6 years in power for President Vladimir Putin, an ex-KGB agent whose surprise appointment by former President Yeltsin has brought what critics call a gradual rollback of democratic freedoms. Putin has abolished most direct elections and put TV channels under Kremlin control.
And this week, Russia passed a new law that tightens the Kremlin's control over nearly a half million non-governmental organizations, or NGOs, many of which have been critical of the president.
Like Human Rights Watch, which says the Kremlin, irked by reports on alleged human rights abuses, could use the new law to close it down.
Putin and his administration want to create totally controlled society.
The law also makes it harder to operate for other prominent U.S. organizations promoting democracy, which Putin has accused of spying, and supporting political revolutions on Russia's borders in Ukraine and Georgia, something the Kremlin doesn't want to spread.
And that's why they need to regulate NGO just to protect any uncontrolled processes.
But the law also hurts Russian NGOs, like Lydia Grafova's, which helps immigrants, but now faces closure. She says the NGO law has scared off donors.
Democracy.
Yet the Kremlin has brushed aside criticism from the U.S. State Department, and there's almost no debate over Putin's policies on Russian TV. Only Kremlin-orchestrated programs about a powerful Russian president ready to take on his critics. In 2006. Preston Mendenhall, NBC News, Moscow.
When NBC Nightly News returns this Sunday, grizzlies at Yellowstone.
Tired of cleaning the old-fashioned way? Brushing, squirting, and sweating. It takes all day. Hi, I'm Mary Ferguson, and those days are over. Introducing Ultimate Scrubber, the new handheld portable power cleaner that does all your household cleaning in half the time. Look, with ordinary brushes, no matter how hard you try, you can only generate around 80 scrubs per minute. But with Ultimate Scrubber, just press the button, and it does 300 scrubs per minute to power clean away dirt and grime like never before. And you don't have to use those harsh chemicals with strong fumes, which make you sick. The secret is our powerful motor that spins nonstop to break up tough stains, supercharging your favorite cleaner to be up to 20 times more effective, guaranteed. Snap on the fabric brush and spot clean stains off laundry. Or use our utility brush to clean up after kids in seconds. Look, cleaning into corners and tight areas is frustrating. But now use our exclusive Twister brush and power clean hard-to-access areas easily and effectively. Ultimate Scrubber even power cleans dust and grime off AC vents in seconds. Ultimate Scrubber even polishes. Now gently restore shine to your wood furniture in no time. Cut your cleaning time in half with Ultimate Scrubber for $19.95. And here's even a better deal. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll give you a second scrubber free. Keep one in your car to help clean up after fast food accidents. And as a special gift, we'll also give you our automotive kit to easily buff those nicks and scratches off your paint. If Ultimate Scrubber is not the most amazing cleaning tool, return it for a full refund of the purchase price. You get it all. Two complete Ultimate Scrubbers, the automotive kit, and the guarantee. An $80 value, all for just $19.95. This is a TV-only offer and is not available in stores, so call now.
To order your Ultimate Scrubber for only $19.95 plus $8.95 shipping, call 1-800-497-0686. Must be 18 or older to call.
This week on Today, it's a new year. Make it a new you. From overcoming fears to organizing your life, our team of experts will help make 2006 your best year ever. Plus, how does your town size up? We've got the list of the fattest and fittest cities in the U.S. That's this week, only on Today on NBC.
A lively discussion of the week's top stories, just like you'd expect between a husband and wife. Weekends with Maury and Connie premieres in 6 days, only on MSNBC.
Credit card minimum skyrocket. NBC Nightly News Monday.
In China, there's reason to celebrate a very good year for a very popular animal. 16 baby pandas were brought together this new year as the nation experiences a panda population boom. A record 25 were born in the country last year. Back here at home, there's a heated debate over a bear that's much less cuddly. The federal government has declared grizzly bears in Yellowstone National Park recovered, clearing the way to remove the once-threatened bear from the endangered list. Here's NBC's Roger O'Neill.
They can make you laugh or make you pause, but the grizzly always makes your heart beat a bit faster.
People fear them because they're big and because they're dangerous and unpredictable. And people love them because they're part of wild nature.
Which in the early days wasn't the case in Yellowstone National Park. They had become garbage dump bears.
They're no different than I am. If you'll cook supper, I'll show up to eat it.
The easy pickings, coupled with other encroachments by man, put the grizzly on a dangerous path to destruction. By 1975, biologist Kerry Gunther says it was clear the grizz needed to be put on the endangered species list.
We've gone from a species that was less than 200 bears and declining to a population now where we have 600 bears and the population's increasing. It's a great success story.
A sorely needed victory for the Endangered Species Act, which some in Washington want to water down. The grizzly is one of only a handful of premier animals to ever be declared recovered.
There have been attempts to take the grizzly off the endangered species list for 10 years now, but getting off is harder than getting on. In 1975, when the bear was listed, it was based on science. To get off the list, you've got to add politics to the equation.
Even today, not all interest groups think the bear is ready.
This is a vulnerable time for the grizzly because we have more and more people moving into the region, creating a noose of human development around an isolated postage stamp of an ecosystem.
But officials say 90% of the bear's habitat, which includes the park and six surrounding national forests, will always be protected. Delisting will give ranchers, among others, more freedom to shoot problem bears. And Tom Bales likes that.
You're looking over your shoulder all the time.
With so many bears now, there are more conflicts with people. But like the wolf, man's tolerance of the big bear will ultimately determine the grizzly's future on the landscape. Roger O'Neill, NBC News, Yellowstone National Park.
That's NBC Nightly News for this Sunday. Thanks for watching. Now here's Ann Curry with a look at what's coming up on Dateline. Ann?
Thanks, John. Did a man who created a program to help troubled kids murder one of them? It was a case that would turn the jury room into a battlefield.
We had reached a verdict, but I don't think anybody was happy that we had reached a verdict.
Murder or accident, the story and the trial coming up on Dateline. John?
Thanks, Ann. That's Dateline tonight at 7, 6 Central. I'm John Seigenthaler, reporting tonight from New York. Happy New Year, and I'll see you again next weekend, if not before.